All right, so down there is the main car park, but I'm going down here. Ups and downs, not too bad though. Our old farm shed. You want to fall down there, would you? Or down there. I'll go and have a look in there. Well, I'll go down the other way. Where I was. So I don't know exactly how to get onto this track other than go down the grass. It's a bit of a funny one. This is it here. Yeah. So the track just sort of starts here without there really being a track leading into it. River's off to my left, in case you get a glimpse of it or hear it. I can probably do this without crashing too badly. Like a pro. Thank you. If you're bushwalking this, especially in the summer, you want to wear long pants. Probably not going to get bitten by a snake, but there's a chance. And if you do get bitten, you're better off if you're wearing long pants. Assuming they're going to bite you on the leg. I've never seen a snake in a tree around here, so don't have to worry about getting bit on the arm. Probably not too many snakes out today. So not particularly sunny and it's not particularly warm, so a lot of extra tracks going off. Now that one probably goes around this bit here, which I got down without dying. Comes down there. Not too sure that way is much better than that way. Anyway, don't think I'll be trying to ride over this. It's a bit dodgy walking over it too. Anyway, not going to fall too far if it breaks. Bridge was okay. I'll give it a load rating of 250 kilos. How's that? A lot easier walking up here without the bike. See how far I get. Not very far. Chickened out. We want to fall off to the left, right here. You got a break in the trees, so see the water. Oh. can sort of see it through there. I think that was the worst part of it, just back there. And from here on, it's actually pretty good. Bike tracks and footprints in the mud. They're a bit of use today. Because I'm going upstream, so in theory, be a little bit easier coming back, in theory. A bit of mud. Yeah, you wouldn't want to be wearing your $400 Nikes and walking on this track. It'll dry out pretty quick though, of course. A few warm days. I think this is the end of the good trail. From memory, you go up here and just sort of, it's more of the same as this. Unless somebody's cut some more tracks in off to the left or something. I'm not sure I can be bothered finding out. interesting geology. Never realised there's a house over there. Pretty cool spot, isn't it? The car parked over there, so it's probably someone living there. When I was younger, a lot younger, I used to see these sort of houses. There's a few of them around on the river, and a lot of them were empty. And then over the years, most of them got burnt down, I assume by vandals. Because that's what you do when you find an empty house, isn't it? You burn it down, and you're a fucking idiot. But anyway, just gonna cruise back and look out for any of those side trails that I saw. A bit of an explore side. A lot easier on the way down. Easy down here. This is the sort of thing I busted my face on 20 or 30 years ago. I was a bit nervous about doing similar things. Not sure I'd do this again. But probably stick to that other track that I was on before I turned off on this one. Ow! Quite a nice hiking track. Not such a good cycling track. Before. Long time ago I stumbled on this. It's a scout chapel from memory. There you go. It's pretty neat here, they've done the concrete on the rocks and the path. Yes, I came from the left. Path keeps going for the right. And main path goes in. Not too sure. I think I'll go up there. That track from the left was sort of shit, so that's probably the same. I think I'll be riding down there. It'll be a good spot to hang out when it's warm. Road I came in on. It's up there. I'm gonna go down there and have a look. Probably just go to the car park. Lutong Bend. So that track there, if you walk and goes to where I looked at that those stairs going down. Ride back to the car. This is the steepest bit. That's the track I went down when I first came in. Up there is back to the car.